on the slow train. Millersdale for Tideswell, Kirby Muxlow, Malcop and Scholar Green. No more will I go to Blandford Forum and Mortyhoe. On the slow train from Midsummer Norton and Mumby Road. No churns, no porter, no cat on a seat at Chorlton, Cumharney or Chester le Street. We won't be meeting again on the slow train. I'll travel no more from Littleton Badsey to Openshaw. At Long Santon I'll stand well clear of the doors no more. No whitewashed pebbles, no up and no down, from Formby Four Crosses to Dunstable Town. I won't be going again on the slow train. On the main line and the good siding, the grass grows high at Dogdyke, Tumby Woodside, and Trouble House Halt. The sleeper sleep at Audlem and Ambergate. No passenger waits on Chitling platform or Cheslin Hay. No one departs, no one arrives, from Selby to Goole, from St. Earth to St. Ives. They've all passed out of our lives on the slow train. On the slow train. Cockermouth for Buttermere.
On the slow train.
Armley Moor, Arran. Pye Hill and Summercoats.
On the slow train.
Windmill End. It's a curious thing, I don't know if you ever thought of this, but England hasn't really got a national song. You know, just for England, there's plenty for Great Britain, but that's quite different. You have to be very careful how you use those terms too. The rule is, if we've done anything good, it's another triumph for Great Britain. And if we haven't, it's England loses again. Have you noticed that? All the others, they got songs about their countries, you know, the Scots, like Scotland for I, or for me, as it should more properly be. And the Welsh and the Irish have got songs saying how marvellous they are and making rude remarks about the English in their own languages. In the case of the Welsh, I think this is the pot calling the saucepan vach. What English national song have we got? Jerusalem. There'll always be an England. Well, that's not saying much, is it? I mean, there'll always be a North Pole. Some dangerous clown doesn't go and melt it. No, I think the reason for this is that in the old days, you know, the good old days when I was a boy, we didn't bother in England about nationalism. I mean, nationalism was on its way out. We got pretty well everything we wanted. And we didn't go around saying how marvellous we were. Everybody knew that. And any more than we bothered to put our names on our stamps. I mean, there's only two kinds of stamps. English stamps, in sets, at the beginning of the album, foreign stamps, all mixed up in the other. any gibbon could tell you that. But nowadays, nationalism is on the up and up, and everybody has a national song but us. Americans have national songs, like My Country, 'Tis of Thee, which they sing to the tune of God Save the Queen, I may say, and which, together with their long-range forecasting of our weather, I find hard to forgive. Yes. The Germans, whatever you say about the Germans, and who doesn't? They marvellous. What a marvellous song that was. German, German overalls. Now, there's a song. Well, The moment has come, and none too soon. We have a song here. We have a song here which I think fills this long-felt what, and I hope that all true-born English men and women in our audience will join in the last chorus. And if you don't have the good fortune to be English true-born, or a man or a woman, I hope you'll join in as an ordinary mark of simple, decent respect. This song starts with, I think, very typical English understatement.